Here we are.
This is the real true blue Dominican cigar factory. And we have Ramon. Ramon is here.
Thank you for sharing today the process of making a fine cigar.
Yeah.
And I would be very happy to let you share with myself and my friends all the process involved.
Yeah, I'll be happy to show you.
Okay, here we are, Ramon. This is the factory for your production. What are the steps? What takes place here?
Yeah, in this factory, well, to make a cigar, you need three steps. It's like separated in three different processes. One is the fermentation process. Then once the tobacco is fermented, you take it to the factory, to the production department. Now we are on the last step on the last process, that is the packing department. When the packing department finishes their job, the cigars are packed and on their way to the customer.
All right, wonderful.
Yeah.
All right, so maybe we could first visit or go to the fermentation room.
Yeah,
all right,
okay.
Wonderful, thank you. Okay.
So we are on the warehouse. When the tobacco comes, from the fields, we put it on this that is called a troja. On a troja, they are fermented. Fermented why? Because when you put it on this, the heat starts to make the tobacco sweat. When they're sweating, is that when they're fermenting. What we do is that here,
you see the temperature? Well, we got the temperature from day to day. We keep track of the temperature. When you know that the temperature is like never doesn't change, then we rotate the ones in the middle to that. We put it down. The ones that are down, we put it on the top, and
okay.
The ones on the top, we put it on the middle.
Excellent.
That's what. Why is that? Because we need to ferment it uniformly every leaf of tobacco.
And that's what is happening right over here.
Yeah, yeah.
They're
putting on trojas. Yeah, that's this. We are. Rotating, you know, putting the ones that were on the middle are the ones that add more heated up, you know, because they got more heat. So we put it on the top, and the top on the middle, and the ones that are on the middle, we put it down. So they can all experience the same process.
Okay.
And be uniformly fermented, you know?
Excellent. All right, here we are. This is the next step.
As I said, when the tobacco comes from the fields, you put it on the troja so they can ferment. The later step is to put water on them. Why? Because you need to take the steam out.
Steam out.
This is where we are.
The stem has to come out.
Yeah, it's called despalillo in Spanish.
Okay.
And what the girl's doing is grabbing a leaf and taking the stem out. You see? Because
okay.
You can't.
I see. It's
you
the
can't
stem.
Work it
it's
on
the
a cigar.
It's the stem that we have to take out.
Yeah, it's the stem.
Okay.
Because you can't put it on cigar with the stem because it will ruin the cigar.
I see. Yeah. All right. Okay. How many steps are we looking at before the cigar is complete?
Well, my uncle always says that a cigar passed through 35 hands before it makes a complete cigar.
Oh, really?
Before it touches the final hand.
Okay.
Cigar smoker hand.
The smoker's hand. Yeah. Excellent.
Yeah.
All right. You mentioned your uncle. What is your place in this venture? Is a family? How many generations?
Yeah, yeah. Actually, I'm a fourth generation cigar maker. My uncle that owns the factory is the third generation. The first one was my great grandfather. He came from Spain, and what he did first is install here in Villa González and place a little cigar factory. Yeah, like 100 years ago. Then pass it to my grandfather, and then that's what like the way my family took. Yeah, this is not my grandfather's company or such like that. It's like Ramon's own personal project. But you know, it's a large tradition of cigar making. Yeah.
Excellent. Excellent. Thank you for sharing that.
As you can see, a cigar is made by two people. One is the roller, and one is called in Spanish the empuñero. The empuñero is the one that grabs the filler and put it in a like a circuit form. So when they put it on a mold, let me show you. That's called the mold, right there.
Okay, we're so, over here with the molds. Yep.
Yeah. When they're taken out of the molds, we have
the rollers here.
This is the empuñero.
Yeah.
He's making bellicosos that cigar. That's the size. They put it on the molds, and when they come out of the molds, déjame coger uno. Yeah. Look, it's still having that's not the shape of a cigar. You have to first put it on the mold. So in the mold, they last like...
Molds over here.
Yeah, they last from 30 minutes to 45. And then we... Andri, pásame uno, por favor. They come out like this. Yeah. Now, this has the shape of a cigar.
So we have the before and after right there. Before and after the mold.
Yeah.
Okay.
So and that's with this is what the roller works with. Yeah, the roller is the cigar maker that puts the wrapper on. Yeah.
And
he
so
puts
far
the filler and the binder.
There's the filler and the binder is the wrapping.
And the binder. So when they put on the mold, when they come out of the mold, you put the wrap on. Yeah.
Okay.
So as you can see, this is a 52x6 cigar. It's okay. Called Bellicoso because it has the pointy finish as a missile, or something. But here in this factory, we make six kind of sizes. We have the Bellicoso, Churchill, Toro, Robusto, and Corona, and Gran Corona. I can show you more.
Why don't we watch the application of the
wrapping?
Of the wrapper itself?
Yeah. Six inches long, and it goes through a 52 ring gauge. Why 52? Well, each number, each unit is 1/64 of diameter of the cigar. So you can figure if you have a 64 ring gauge cigar, then you have a 1-inch diameter.
Excellent.
Cigar, yeah.
Okay.
And for example, this is a Bellicoso, but we have the Gran Corona, Extra Corona. Let me grab you one. This is 43x6.5. You can see here, 43. 43 is here. It passed through the 43 ring gauge. And it's 43x6.5 inches.
Exactly,
yeah.
6.5 inches.
Yeah,
excellent. Okay.
this is where the tobacco is given to the cigar makers.
Yeah.
We have, for each boxes, we have a different kind of tobacco. And each box is for a different size. For example, these three boxes are for the short shells. Short shells are 50 by 7.5. The next three are for the Bellicosos and the Toros. And the last two are for the Robustos. For example, let me show you the tobacco of a short shell. Well, a tobacco, a cigar, is made by three different kind of leaves. Well, the filler, you know? We have a one leaf that's called seco. This seco, it hasn't much smell or taste, but it's good for the cigar, so it can burn better because it has less moisture and less, you know, nutrients and stuff like that. A cigar made entirely by seco isn't gonna taste much or smell much, but it's sure gonna burn well. Yeah. So to make the strength of the cigar, to make the strength go up, you use a ligero. This is called ligero. It's a much stronger taste, a much stronger smell, and we have two kinds of ligero. This is ligero dominicano. Ligero dominicano, why? You can see because when it's Dominican, the top of the leaf is like pointy. You see it's pointy?
Okay.
So you can identify it's a Lord Dominicano leaf.
Yeah.
This is the Cuban ligero. You will see the Cuban ligero is much more like gross.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yep. It's more white. Yeah, this is a Cuban ligero. So you use different kinds of tobacco because when you mix it, you blend it, by each tobacco you have, you make a different essence. Maybe we switch the Dominican ligero and put another type of Dominican ligero, and the essence of that cigar will change.
Okay.
Just by making one leaf change. That's on the filler.
Okay.
Yeah. So you know the empuñero needs to have a binder. So we here, yeah, this is for the tobacco of the Coronas. You see the Corona is a much smaller cigar.
Okay.
You saw the difference? This is for the short shells.
Yeah.
And this is for the Corona. This is a Corona seco.
The leaves are sized to the size of the cigar that they're gonna be made of.
Yeah, yeah. This is a Bellicoso binder. It's the one in the one in the middle, you know, the size.
Okay.
And this binder is called, it's type Sumatra from Indonesia. Yeah. The wrapper, as you can see, as I will show you, is from Connecticut wrapper. This is Indonesia binder.
All
the
right.
Filler are Dominicans and Cuban.
Okay.
And the last one, the one from the short show. This is the binder they use for the short show. Size 17. You know, it's the largest
of them all.
Yeah, because the short show is the largest cigar, so you need a larger binder.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, in this factory, the cigars are sold in bundles. A bundle normally has 20 cigars. What she's doing is because maybe all the cigars have the same wrapper, Connecticut wrapper, but not always they're gonna have the same color or the same tonifications. So what she's doing is she's separating the cigars to make them all have the same uniform color. You know, for example, this will be a future bundle, this will be another bundle, this will be another bundle. So they
all she's looking for here is the color.
To match the
colors.
To make
sure the colors are the same.
Yeah, because maybe if you found in a bundle this with this, you're gonna see that they have
slightly different shade.
Yeah, maybe we don't see it, but she sees it. Yeah.
Right.
So that's when she matched the cigars, then we put it on the packing department so they can be packed and ready to go.
We are in the packing department.
Yeah, so the packing department has also a section in almost three kind of packing types, like someone are making rings. Actually, at this time, we are not making cigars with rings.
No rings at this time, but putting the cellophane and putting them in the packages, and wrapping them.
Yeah, on the cellophane and putting on the packing sheet, on the packing, and making the bundles. So the bundles can be shipped to the customer, and the cigar can be smoked.
Perfect.
Yeah. Because you know you can't work all the cigars at the very same day. You have to storage them. So you need to storage them on a humid room so they can be moisture. So when the girls are working it, the wrapper wouldn't fill up, because if the cigar is dry, like if you leave it right here outside, they will dry. And when they put the rings on it, the rubber will fill up.
So now we're gonna go and visit your humidor and come in and see how this is.
Yeah. So here you can feel like the essence of the cigars.
Ah, it's wonderful.
Strongly,
aroma.
Yeah. So this is where we storage them till we need them. The girls need them, and they can start the packing process of this.
See.
Yeah.
So it's here first, and then the packing process.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Armando. It's been a wonderful tour.
Yeah.
We've learned a lot.
You're very welcome.
Thank you.
Yeah. Take care.